Dear students, welcome back to computer science class. So today we will solve the boolean expression. With the help of boolean laws, so we have to solve the boolean expressions. Okay, so yesterday I given some examples. Okay, so today I will solve those examples. So the first expression is x bar y bar z plus x bar y z plus x y bar. Okay, so this is the expression. So with the help of laws, so we have to solve the boolean expression. The main intention of boolean expression is to reduce, to minimize the given expression as much as possible. We have to minimize the expression, that is the intention. Okay, see here, first term is x bar y bar z is there, here x bar y z is there. So observe the terms here. Here the common term is x bar z, here x bar z, so that's why we can take common, that is x bar z. So within the bracket here y bar is there, plus here y is there, plus x y bar as it is. X bar z plus y plus y bar or y bar plus y, it is the complementary law. The complementary law is x plus x bar is equal to 1. Means it is 1 plus x y bar. X bar z plus x y bar. Okay, so again it is possible or not possible to solve. Okay, see here, x bar z is there, here x y bar is there. So there is no common term. It means this is the answer. Again, it is not possible to solve. If it is common term, it is possible to solve. But here there is no common term, means this is the minimized expression. Okay, so this is the first one. The second one is x y z plus x y z w plus x z. See here, x y z is there, here also x y z is there. The common term is x y z, in the bracket 1 plus of w, again plus of x z. X y z in the bracket of 1 plus w, bracket close, plus of x, y, z as it is, 1 plus any variable is equal to 1 plus x, z. X, y, z into 1, x, y, z plus x, z. Again, it is possible to solve because the common term here x, z is there, here also x, z is there. It means we can take x, z as a common term. Okay, so here y plus 1. 1 plus 5 is 1, xz into 1 is xz. So this is the final answer. Okay. To solve the boolean expression, compulsory we have to remember the laws of boolean algebra. Then only it is possible to solve. Otherwise it is difficult to solve. Okay, so the boolean algebra chapter is very important for the examination also. So total 13 marks you will get in this chapter. Okay, the next expression is z in the bracket of y plus z. Z in the bracket of y plus z in the bracket x plus y plus z. Z in the bracket of y plus z in the bracket x plus y plus z. Okay. So in this case, first we can multiply. Here z is there, here y is there. This is yz plus z into z. Next, x plus y plus z. See here. Here yz plus z into z. X into x is equal to x only. So that's why yz plus z is as it is. X plus y plus z. Next is, see here, yz plus z. Okay, so the common term is z in the bracket of y plus 1. X plus y plus z. See here, 1 plus y or y plus 1 is 1 only. So finally, it becomes z into x plus y plus z. Because yz plus z is there, the common term is z. So if you take the z as a common means within the bracket y plus 1, here 1 plus y or y plus 1 is equal to 1 only. So 1 into z, z next as it is, x plus y plus z. So next is, again you can multiply z into x, xz plus yz plus z into z. See here, xz as it is plus yz plus z into z. One time z only. See here, common term again z. X plus y plus 1. See here, first we can consider this one. Z as it is, x as it is, plus 1 plus y or y plus 1. 1 plus any variable is equal to 1 only. 1 plus or x plus 1 is again 1. Finally, we get this result as that only. So like this we have to solve the expression. So it is very very important, and almost one thing we have to remember is we have to remember 3 to 4 formulas, that is complementary laws, distributive law, and this 1 plus y or 1 plus x, x into x, x plus x. So all these laws are very very important. Okay, so maximum we have to use these laws only. So this is the third one. See here, z, y, z is the bracket of y plus z is there. Here x, y, z is there. So first I can multiply. So after multiplying we will get y, z plus z into z. So z into z is equal to z only. See here, x into x is equal to x. The same law is applied here. So finally we will get y, z plus z. So this term is as it is. See here, the common term is z. Y plus 1, that is 1. Finally, we get z into x plus y plus z. Again, we can multiply. Again, z into z, z only. Again, the z is common term, that is x plus y plus 1. 1 plus any variable is 1. Again, x plus 1. Finally, we will get the result as z. So, another one is there. Fourth one, x plus x bar y
plus y bar plus
x plus
y bar into x bar
into x bar y.
So this is the expression.
Okay,
see here. X as it is, x bar y plus y bar plus. So just you can multiply. X into x bar y. X into x bar y plus y bar x bar. X plus x bar y plus y bar.
Plus, see here,
x into x bar is 0, 0 into y is 0 plus. Here x bar is there, here y bar is there, here y is there, y into y bar or y bar into y is 0, 0 into x is again 0. So finally the result, last three terms are remaining, x, x bar, y plus y bar.
Okay,
see here. Again it is possible to reduce x into x bar y plus y bar. See here. X plus yz is equal to x plus y into x plus z. So this is the distributive law. So you can apply the distributive law for these two terms. So after applying the distributive law, it becomes x plus x bar into x plus y plus of y plus of
y bar.
See here, x plus x bar is 1 into x plus y plus y bar. So here plus is there, so directly you can write x plus y plus y bar. See here, so what is y plus y bar? Y plus y bar is again 1. So x plus 1. So 1 plus any variable or x plus 1 is equal to 1. Finally the result is 1.
Okay. So like this we have to solve the Boolean expressions. Okay.
So next another example.
Another example.
Fifth one. A bar plus B.
A bar plus B.
Into A plus.
Into A plus B. So instead of using x, y, z, they have to use a and b variables.
Okay. So in this case, so just you can multiply a bar into a, that is a bar plus a bar into b, a bar b plus b into a or a into b plus b into b. So after multiplying, see here, what is x into x bar? That is 0. Here same, instead of x, here a term, a variable is there, a into a bar is 0 plus a bar b plus a b, b into b is b only. See the common term here, b is a common term, a bar plus a plus 1, a plus 1 is, suppose if you apply a plus a bar as a complementary law, it becomes 1. 1 plus 1 is 2. So don't apply complementary law here. Okay. See here, b. First you can consider 1 plus any variable, that is 1 only, a bar plus 1. Again 1 plus any variable is 1. Finally the result is b.
Okay. Suppose if I apply the complementary law for a plus a bar or a bar plus a, means its answer is 1. 1 plus 1, it is 2. Okay. For that purpose, 1 plus a.
Or 1 plus 1, if we consider the logical or, means again it is 1.
But in generally, 1 plus 1 is 2, means don't write 2 here. Okay. With respect to the Boolean algebra, 1 plus 1 is 1 only. But in general, if you consider 1 plus 1 is 2, don't write 2b. Okay. So this is the another expression. Next.
Another example. Sixth one.
AB
plus AB plus AB bar plus a bar b. So ab plus ab bar plus a bar b. See the common term here. Here a is there, here also a is there, so I can take the a as a common. If you take a as a common, means it become b plus b bar, bracket close, plus a bar. B plus b bar is 1, that is a plus a bar b. So again you can apply the distributive law. After applying distributive law, it become a plus a bar into a plus b. A plus a bar is 1, 1 into a plus b is equal to a plus b. So this is the final answer. So again it is not possible to reduce, that's why the result is a plus b. Okay. Next, last example. B is the bracket of A plus C plus AB bar plus BC bar plus C.
AB bar plus BC bar
plus C. So first you can multiply, that is AB plus BC plus AB bar plus BC bar plus C. So if we consider AB and AB bar, AB plus AB bar, first you can write, the next I can write BC plus BC bar plus C. In these two terms, A is a common, B plus B bar. In these two terms, B is common, that is C plus C bar. Finally, C as is. B plus B bar is 1, that is A. C plus C bar is 1, that is B. Finally, we get the C. That the result is A plus B plus C. So again, it is not possible to solve the expression. Finally, the result is A plus B plus C. Okay. So like this, we can solve the Boolean expression. Okay. So in the exercise also, they have to given some examples. So as much as possible, we can solve the expression. Okay. In the next class, we will discuss the some more examples. Thank you.